Well, hey there, YouTube fellow silver stackers, silver pourers, silver enthusiasts, anyone who dropped in to see some silver pouring, subscribed or not, thank you. We will try and get a few states done here this weekend. I think we're going to do another multi-part video because it's going to take a little long if I do all four or five in one shot. So we'll stretch that out so you don't have to watch anything too crazy long. I do have some silver here left from before. I got one of the 10-ounce bars left, a 2-ounce, this is around 3, this is around 3. I'm going to probably melt these down. They haven't gone anywhere, haven't moved. We've also got the hexagon here I may melt down as well, since it hasn't gone anywhere. But this one I may save till the end, since I did also just get 60 more buffalo rounds. Came in the mail yesterday, but we'll get started here, start tracing these out. As you can see, I've got Iowa, Arkansas, Kansas, and Missouri to trace out here. I do have the stencils made, of course, and tacked on there, as you can see. So hold tight, we'll come right back. So I just said I'm going to show a little bit of the how-to here in this first part for at least my process. First off, I'm using redwood, just dry regular redwood, nothing special about it, and cut off a piece. I got an 8-foot length of it to begin with and working its way down. But as you can see, I've got the shapes here. So the next step, I go through and trace everything out. I will likely speed this part up, so here goes with a little bit of time lapse. So there is that, and as you saw with each one in the time lapse, go through and take the nails out after and make sure that I got everything in the way of the outline. If I need to, right here is kind of missing a little bit, but that's fairly easy because that's all mostly a straight part here after that little curve, so you can fill that in. A couple spots, make them a little bit darker because it does help to have them darker when you're going through with the next part, which is the routing part. I'll go ahead and darken some of these up, but that's kind of the general idea there. So let me get the router ready and reposition the camera, and we'll get on to the next part. I do see now, looking at the video, it's a little bit, whoops, there go the nails, but there you go. There are the four states traced out, so I will see in a moment. Little repositioning and little routing. Hold tight. Okay, got the router ready and plugged in. Got the board clamped down so it doesn't move while routing. I have a 1/4-inch bit on here. Just a straight cutting bit. Nothing special about it. It's only maybe a 1/4-inch deep. So the first step I do, I go through and get the general shape done. And then I swap over to the Dremel style router with a 1/16-inch bit. It might even be a little smaller than that. I'll double check before I start. But I think it's a 1/16-inch. So it's quite a bit smaller. I can get the detail quite a bit better. So it might be loud. It might not be, because I'm going to try and do a little time lapse again here. So hold tight. Volume down just in case I leave it. But this should take a little longer than necessary to let it run the full time, so I will time lapse, but here goes. So there you can see how I do just the general outline and get as close as I can. So we'll come right back for the detail part. Hold tight. All right, so here we go with the next part. Can you see I got the little tiny 1/16-inch bit here on the Dremel? I got an attachment to use it like a router, so that makes it handy. But like I said before, I like to get as close to these lines as I can so I don't burn up this bit trying to do a full cut on the pieces. So let's get this plugged in and then get these the rest of the way shaped out. So we will get a little noisy again here possibly, but I do plan to do a bit of time lapse. So hold tight, sit back and relax, and here's goes the detail portion. Well, there we go. Got all the detail done. So that is the process, at least that I use for this part. I have seen a few others, like Vulcan 5678. He has a little vacuum attached to his. He's got a little bit smaller unit, so he can kind of use it one hand operation. This one kind of needs two. It's got a funky little speed dial there, so I kind of have to hold that in place. But also, it's got the two handles. So it makes it easier to get the finer details there that way. But we will come back here for part two. That is the end of part one. Thank you for stopping in. We'll, like I said, break this up a little bit. So hold tight and I'll see you soon for part two. Thank you all for stopping by. Like, share, comment, subscribe. It's all greatly appreciated. And I will see you next time. AGN, you're signing off. Have a good day.